I think with the real music people, and I don't care whether they're doing rap or rock or country, with the real music people, it doesn't make a difference. I think there's so many superficial people in our business now. And I mean, I don't want to knock any successes, but we played because we wanted to play music. You practiced because you wanted to get better so you could play better music. Many times, me, your dad, John Guerin, Earl, I mean, two drummers, three guitar players, all together, go hear another musician. You can't get these young kids to go listen to them. I mean, how much are you getting paid? Man, I don't know. I'm sitting around all night for nothing. See, but we went not only to add support, but to learn, because you can learn from each other, you know. You can't do that anymore. You know, nobody wants to show anything. Nobody wants to share anything with anybody. So, but that was just, you know, it wasn't like, I'm playing better than you, or I'm going to get the solo. It wasn't about that. People just want to pay enough now to get their little CD done so they can go out and make some money. You know, and so, but that's not just in the music. That's in all walks of life right now. We played because we wanted to play music. Of course we wanted to make money. Of course we wanted to do well and be successful. But we played because we wanted to do music. Today, I don't think that's the prime thing that people get into the business for. Studios now that have a room with a sauna and a, you know, listening chamber and a meditation room so you can listen to your playback. So if you're clocking out $200 an hour and you're sitting in the sauna listening to your playback, I mean, that's money that has nothing to do with the quality of the record. Back in those days, every label had a black male singer. I was singing at a club one night, and Dick Pierce came in and heard me, one of the executives at RCA. And at that time, Jesse Belvin had just been killed in an accident, and Sam Cooke was in. So they had no black singer, so I was going to be the next guy. They had a guy named Sam Fletcher, but he was a jazz singer. They wanted somebody who could sing soul. I kept saying, I can't. Oh, no, you got soul. So I became a soul singer. And funny enough, my records are selling now on the internet for more than I ever made when I was a singer.